What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing analysis on GGPI ticker. And on today's video, first of all, I will show you the price chart and how we get to this point. Then I will show you some fundamentals and I will tell you why this company is so interesting for now. And we will continue with the technical analysis and with the probable outcome for this stock. And before we get into all of that, if you guys would like to take a part in the limited time promo offer from Webull and earn 2 free stocks valued up to $2,300, just open new account, deposit only $5 and choose your free stocks. Link in my description. So, and let's begin with the price chart. As you can see, we have the latest data of May the 28th, 2021. And this company is basically very new company. It is a SPAC company. And let me show you what does it mean. Special Purpose Acquisition Company is a company with no commercial operations that is formed strictly to raise capital through an initial public offering for the purpose of acquiring an existing company, also known as blank check companies. So this company doesn't have any fundamentals behind it for now, but they have a lot of rumors, and as you can see, these rumors heavily impacted to this price. And as you can see, from this bottom to this top, this ticker has more than 12% of potential profits, and for now it has a decline of about 6%, and we don't have much data. That's why from the technical standpoint it is rather difficult to make any assumptions. And that is why I waited for quite some time in order to have just a couple of major pivot points in order to make some projections. But let's continue with the fundamentals and let me show you this news. On Seeking Alpha, on July the 8th, we have this article and it's titled Gors Guggenheim SPAC gains on report of talks to take electric car maker Polestar public. And here are the bullets, let me quote it for you. SPAC Gor Guggenheim rose 5.6% on a report that it is discussions to take electric car maker Polestar public in a deal that could value the EV maker around $25 billion. No deal has been finalized and it is possible nothing could happen, according to a Bloomberg report. This is a very important statement. Next one, Polestar is the EV maker that's controlled by Volvo Car and the Chinese Xinjiang Geely. The Wall Street Journal reported in April that Volvo Cars and Geely were planning to take their e-Swedish electric vehicle maker company Polestar public by merging with another SPAC and boosting its valuation to as much as $40 billion. Polestar has been a standalone brand since 2017 and focuses on high-performance electric cars. The company in April was wrapping up a Series A fundraising round that would value it at $7 billion and is aiming for a Series B fundraising that was expected to boost its valuation to $20 billion by the end of June before merging with a SPAC to go public. Bloomberg was the first to report in March that Polestar was said to be exploring an IPO in the United States or Hong Kong or potentially a SPAC deal. And this is very important that for now we have only rumors. And as you might remember, we had roughly the same rumors around the merger between CCIV and Lucid Motors. And since then, we have a huge spike in price. We had a huge spike in price for CCIV ticker, and let me show it to you. Here is the point where we had first rumors, and since then the top price was at about 6x from the base price, and it is extremely high price movement. So, we might have something similar with this ticker, but I have to warn you that nothing is guaranteed. So, let's continue with some news about the Polestar itself. And let me quote you this. Polestar is currently retailing two cars, the hybrid Polestar 1 that costs over $150,000 and the all-electric Polestar 2 that starts retailing at $59,900 and boasts of a range of around 260 miles. In addition, the Polestar 3 SUV and the Polestar Pre-Seat, a Tesla Model S competitor, are currently in the prototype phase. The company is currently manufacturing its vehicles in Geely-owned facilities in China. However, the Polestar 3 would be produced in Volvo's Ridgeville, South Carolina facility. And let me show you this. Here is the Polestar 2. all-electric vehicle, and here is their hybrid, Polestar 1. And also they have a prototype of their SUV, and as you can see, they didn't disclose the interior and exterior of this car. So, and let me show you some interesting details about this company. As far as the company's financials are concerned, the company earned $645 million in revenue 2020, registering a growth of over 600% relative to the 2019 top line figure. And as you can see, this company has a very good year-over-year growth. And in my opinion, this might be very good potential, because Geely and Volvo are very strong companies that owns the Polestar. And with this SPAC, they might achieve the valuation of Polestar for more than $40 billion. And let me show you institutional investors of this company, of GGPI ticker. And as you can see, we don't have any filings for now. But on the other hand, if we switch to short interest of this ticker, we have 11.49% of short volume ratio. And right here we have the latest data of 13.39%. So this stock is already shorted, and that's why you have to be extremely cautious, because nothing is confirmed, and that's why we might have a price action either way. We might go south or we might go north. Of course, we all expecting to move this price to all-time high, but we have to be extremely cautious. So, and let's continue with the technical analysis. But before we dive deep right here, please subscribe to my channel, hit notification bell, and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. As you can see, we don't have much data, and that's why it is very difficult to rely on the indicators. As you can see, we have just several days on RSI, and we don't have any information on MACD, because MACD has to have an information from the previous several days. And the more information this indicator has, the more accurate it is. So, and that's why we have to rely only on the price action. And as you can see, we have three major pivot points for now. This is the lowest point, this is the highest, and this is the lowest point of the retracement so far. And we can measure this movement with the Fibonacci retracement tool from the bottom to the very top. And as you can see, we hit 0.5 level, and basically we poke it through. And for now, we are hovering in the middle of range 0.5 and 0.618. This means we might easily hit this level of 0.618 and 0.65, and this is the most probable level of trend reversal. So, what to expect next from this ticker? If you believe that these rumors will become reality and the Polestar will have a merger with GGPI, and I think it will happen, and in this case you might enter your position on opening hours, or you can use some brokerage that allows you to use fully extended hours, like Webull brokerage. And by the way, you can use my referral link in the description below. And what to expect next? What might be the next movement? If this is the lowest point, we can project some target for the third wave. Let me clean the chart a little bit. And to project targets, I pull the Fibonacci extension tool from the very bottom to the very top and to the bottom of the retracement. And with the assumption that we have to land the top of our third wave, and as you might see, the rumors might drive the price of this ticker extremely high, but let's be conservative. And first of all, let me show you that we might hit the level of 1.618, and it is roughly $12.21 mark. And the most aggressive target for now is $13.43. And from our current price, we might have about, let me show it to you, we might have about 19% to our first target and about 31% to our second target. It is not so big gains, but nevertheless, it will be only the next potential move to the upside. And the more rumors we will have and the more confirmation we will have, the higher price will be. So, in my opinion, this ticker has a huge potential, and that's why you have to keep an eye on this ticker. So, from the technical standpoint, I think that's it for now. If you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel with notification bell. And see you guys and girls next time. Bye!